Namaste. Welcome to the session of Magnetic Field Intensity on the axis of circular loop. Myself, Rohini Mergu, working as an associate professor at Walchand Institute of Technology in the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering. Learning outcomes. At the end of this video, you will be able to apply Biot-Savart's law to derive magnetic field intensity on the axis of circular loop. Determine the direction of magnetic field intensity for a given circular loop. Now, before we proceed further, as we said, we are able to apply the Biot-Savart's law. So, let us recall the equation of Biot-Savart's law. So, this is the equation of Biot-Savart's law. H bar is equal to closed line integral of I dl bar cross ar bar upon 4 pi r square, where I stands for current. Dl bar is a small section of the filament, but it's a vector quantity. We consider its direction as the direction of the current. R is the distance between the filament and the point P, where we want to find the magnetic field. AR bar is the unit vector in the direction of R, and X is not just, it's a X, it's not a simple multiplication. This is a cross product. H on the axis of the circular loop that we want to find out. So, let us consider the XYZ system. In this, let us assume a circular current carrying loop is placed in XY plane at Z equal to 0, centered at origin. So, consider this loop which is centered at origin. Consider that this loop is carrying current in this direction, in anti-clockwise direction, having the current as I. Let us assume point Q at 0, phi Z, where we want to find the magnetic field intensity due to this circular current carrying conductor. So, for that, let us assume a small section of the filament dl bar. Consider the point on this dl bar as r phi 0. The coordinates here has come as r phi 0 because point P is at certain radius and it lies on the plane phi, constant plane. So, r phi. As I said that the loop is centered at origin and placed in xy plane with z equal to 0. So, z is coming to be 0. Now, as I want to find the field due to this loop at this point, at point Q, join the point P to point Q. So, this is the line which is joined. Here, we want to find out the dH bar due to this section of the filament, and then we'll find for the complete loop. Consider the line which is joining from P to Q is R, but show the arrowhead towards point Q where we want to find the field. So, this vector comes to be R bar. Now, start deriving. According to Biot-Savart's law, H bar is equal to I dl bar cross AR bar upon 4 pi R square. All this is inside the closed line integral. But recall the previous diagram. In this diagram, we have drawn everything. This loop is there, but we are first trying to find out dH bar for this small section of dl bar. We want to find dH bar for the small section of dl bar. So that, let us modify the equation, remove the integral sign and write dH bar, which is I dl bar cross AR bar upon 4 pi R square. Now, dl bar here can be given as R d phi A phi. Why R d phi A phi? Because dl bar is this circular section, circular part. Here I am considering the cylindrical coordinate system. In cylindrical coordinate system, the coordinates are R, phi and Z. And this circular section all the time corresponds to phi. So, this part is, the length is r d phi and the unit vector is a phi bar. When I multiply it with I get I r d phi a phi bar. and R bar. Now I want to find R bar because I want to substitute these values in the equation. I want to find R, I want to find AR, IDL bar already I have calculated. So R bar is head minus tail. This arrow head is Q and arrow tail is P. So Q coordinates minus P coordinates will give me R bar. So it is 0 minus R AR, 5 minus 5 goes to be 0 next, plus Z minus 0 AZ bar. So this is my R bar. Now find here, I just want the magnitude. So let us find the magnitude of R bar, which is under root of R square plus Z square, squaring and adding the terms. AR bar is nothing but a vector upon its magnitude. So this vector divided by this magnitude is AR bar. Now substitute AR bar, IDL bar as well as R bar in this equation of DH bar. So again recall, IDL bar is this, AR bar is this, R bar is this, or modulus of R bar is given by this equation. So substitute all this in the equation of DH bar. So first let us substitute IDL bar, then substitute AR bar, then substitute R bar, so that I'll get DH bar like this. Now I can simplify this equation. I can write this raised to half and this is a square. I can combine this together and that goes to be raised to 3 by 2. So I can write DH bar as IR d phi a phi cross minus R AR plus Z AZ divided by 4 pi R square plus Z square raised to 3 by 2. So DH bar is this. Now this is not a simple cross, it's a cross product. So to find the cross product, I need to follow this triangle. Here I want the cross product of A phi with R. So A phi with R, I am going in the opposite direction of the arrow. Of course the result is AZ, but it is either positive or negative, that depends on the direction of the arrow. As I am finding out A phi cross AR, I am going in the opposite direction of the arrow, so my result is minus AZ. Again, I also want the cross product of A phi cross AZ. So A phi cross AZ, I am going in the same direction of the arrow, so my result is AR. So these are the results which I need to substitute in the equation. So this is minus AZ, already minus sign is there, so it comes to be RAZ, and here A phi cross AZ will give me this AR. So this is my equation. Fine, this is DH bar. Now to find H bar, I need to integrate all the elements from 0 to 2 pi of DH bar. All the DL bars together from 0 to 2 pi will give me H bar. So while integrating, let us think a bit on this. In DH bar, there are two terms. One is AZ bar term, another is AR bar term. What I mean by this is, this DL bar has two components, AR bar and AZ bar. So when I am trying to integrate, what happens is, there is a diametrically opposite point to the point P, which is also having the two components, AR and AZ, like this. Now if you observe carefully, this AR and this AR are exactly in the opposite direction. So they cancel each other, and this AZ and this AZ both are in the same direction. So they sum up when we integrate. So for every DL bar, there is another DL bar diametrically opposite to it, with which all the AZ bar components gets added and AR bar components get omitted. So that while integrating, omit AR bar components and consider only AZ bar components. So again, let us see this equation, where you can see I have omitted AR bar component and I have taken only RAZ in the bracket. So this comes to be I R square AR upon 4 pi R square plus Z square raised to 3 by 2 integral of D phi. So d phi is, phi is from 0 to 2 pi. So integration gives me the result as 2 pi. So finally my answer is I r square upon 2 r square plus z square raised to 3 by 2 az bar. Unit of magnetic field intensity is amperes per meter. Density. This is the magnetic field intensity due to circular current carrying conductor when I find it on the z axis. So the unit vector has come as az. Now let us look at the quantities. In this equation, I is the current, r is the radius of the circular current carrying conductor or a filament. Z is nothing but the perpendicular distance between the center of the circular filament to the point P. Az bar is the unit vector indicating the direction of the magnetic field. Now let us think about the direction. Now as I said in the previous derivation, the direction is az bar. But whether it's all the time az bar, let us look at this. The direction of magnetic field intensity is given by right-handed thumb rule like this. If thumb is indicating the direction of the field, then curved finger will be indicating direction of current, or curved finger will be indicating direction of field and thumb will be indicating the direction of current. But here I am considering a circular loop, so current will be flowing with can be shown with my curved fingers and thumb will be indicating the the field direction is decided by the direction of the current. With this knowledge, I want to ask you a question. What will be the direction of H if point Q is below the circular loop? If point Q is below the circular loop, what I mean is this is the point Q, but if I consider it below here. So whether there will be any change in this equation? So let us look at the answer. If point Q is below the circular loop, still the direction of H is az only, because the direction of H bar is decided by right-handed thumb rule, which is dependent on the current direction and it is independent on the position of point Q. Let me ask you one more question. If point Q is at the center of the circular loop, what will be the change in the below equation, in this equation? So if point Q is here, instead of here, if the point Q is here, what change will be there? So naturally, this Z is going to be 0. So the answer is, if Q is at the center of the circular loop, Z is equal to 0. So equation will be modified as I by 2 R AZ bar. These are the references used for preparing this video. Thank you.